Okay, so guys are going to talk about this interview that we're going to have now. It's about Antonio Tron. Antonio dos Passos Tron. He's an absolutely legend from Brazil. He was my idol back in the days, like still, you know. Amazing pro skateboarder, you know, like super respected, like around the world with his skate, the street skate.
My name is Antonio dos Passos Jr. The people call me Tron. It's my nickname. I'm from Brazil. San Gonzalo, Rio de Janeiro, but I grew up in São Paulo.
Where in São Paulo?
São Paulo, Vila Madalena, Vila Mariana.
Sick. How, what's your relation with Venice Beach?
My relation with Venice Beach is because I'm a skateboarder for a long time. I do street, you know? I'm the first champion of street in Brazil. 1987, Guaratinguetá, São Paulo.
When did you get here in Venice?
I came in Venice 1996, my first time here.
Sick. Did you get to meet Jay Adams and these guys?
Yeah, Jay Adams was my friend. I smoked a lot of cigarettes with him and talk about skateboard all the time. He's a very nice guy. And we talk about skateboard in Brazil. Talk about skateboarding everywhere, you know. He's a very nice guy. He loves surfer, and he's a very good surfer.
Were you in Venice when he died?
Yes, I was here at the time.
Yeah, so pretty much, tell me about how was your skateboard life, like as a professional skateboarder.
I was skateboard professional. I had a Christian Rossoy sponsor, Rossoy team, you know, in Brazil. And I had a Mad Rat shoes. I have my deck from Lifestyle Skateboards. The first deck in the world has a Apta nose, you know? And the model for street, a very special model. And nowadays it's still the best seller deck in Brazil.
Really?
Yeah.
And what about Lifestyle? I remember the Lifestyle Tron.
Lifestyle is a brand that made my deck, you know? But the Lifestyle skateboard is the love for the skateboard. It's the passion for skateboard, you know?
Funny story, like a beautiful story, like that. I started to skate in Brazil, and then like I started to surf right after. But I came from a family that, unfortunately, my mom like didn't have my dad next to me, you know, and I was like, I think it was Christmas time, and then I was like, Mom, I want a gift, you know, and I'm sure in that time my mom couldn't buy like that, like, but she made it happen, and the gift was a skate deck, you know, where Tron was sponsored by Lifestyle, you know, and the model was Tron model, you know. And that was my idol, you know, how can I say, you know, and then I started to skate well with the best deck, you know, from Tron's model from Lifestyle. I skated with a skateboard, and I never thought that I would meet Tron in my life, you know, because I was a little kid, you know, and then, like, after a while, like, my life went through, you know, and then, like, I moved to California, and then, like, as soon as I got in Venice Beach, in Venice, you know, in Los Angeles, I was in Venice, and then I met this guy, like, Brazilian, you know, and that was Tron, you know, and then I'm like, wow! I'm meeting my idol here, you know, and what a crazy situation, because like 30 plus years after I got my the deck, you know, I met my idol, you know, and I was like, oh man, like you Tron, I can't believe it, you know, like he was friends with Jay Adams, he was friends with tons of legends here in Venice, you know, and he got my back right away, you know, like he introduced me a lot of people too, you know, and I was like, wow, what a crazy world, like how God is like looking to me, you know. Venice gave to us this opportunity to be friends with them, you know, and I'm beyond thankful, like, for Venice, you know, and for all these people that are part of my life. He came into this country and had to work hard, you know, as I did too. And if you see how Tron is, he's one of the most humble guys that I ever met. That's the beauty about him, you know, like, even though he was one of the best skateboarders in the world, he never bragged about it. All he cares is about, like, to live his life, like, in a simple way, you know. He went through a lot of things after his pro skateboarding. You know, he had like a little disability because of skateboarding, you know, and we became friends. We started to talk a lot, like, and then like after a while, he came to me and he said, hey, Wagner, I'm gonna have a surgery. And I think after a long time without skating, I'm gonna be able to skate again. And then I'm like, oh God, thank you so much. Like, I'm so happy with that, you know, like. Tron had a surgery. He's skating again.
Skateboard is for fun, you know? Skateboarding started on the street, you know? And the hills is a lot of fun, you know? If you're gonna go pro, oh, that's okay. But when you became older, you come back to fun, for fun.
Manda. O que você quiser ainda. Yeah, Tron, thank you so much, man.
Thanks so much, Wagner. Appreciate your help, man.
Also, question for you. Do you want to inspire the kids, like the new generation, to skate, like, or to be better versions of themselves?
Yeah, I think. The kids right now is a different time, you know. Right now the skate is Olympic, you know, it's different time. That's good for skateboard. That's good for the Olympics too, you know. Yeah, I think the kids right now is gonna be better, and the skater from Brazil is gonna be great. Pedro Barros, you know, Fadinha, Raíssa, you know, these kids, I have a proud for this kid because they became for the us, you know, coming from us.
It's the next generation after yours, right?
Yeah, yeah. I have a lot of respect for generation. All right.
Awesome. Thank you, Tron.
You're welcome, man. Venice Beach, art die. Always.
This guy came from a place which there is not many opportunities. Our life over there is very hard, you know, we live in a war, you know, like how I say, it's a drug war, you know, like the police, the gangsters, you know, like they are everywhere. But we found through skateboard and surf, like our way to enjoy life, you know, and Tron is a pioneer of this story. And it made me be so grateful for what I have, you know, and a lot more to come, you know. I'm gonna interview him again soon, and just remember that a lot of people, they don't have food, you know, clothes, skateboards, you know, like surfboards, wetsuits. Like, thank God that we live here in the United States, we have opportunity to have all of this, you know. So, yeah, let's enjoy our lives, let's be grateful. And let's try to make this planet a better place, you know, and the law of giving and receiving is a fact. If you want to receive, you need to start to give.